Yeah, so what we're looking at here is the rifle that was taken from Chief Poundmaker in 1885. It's something very special, very unique, and we're proud to have it.
That gun is the centerpiece of a new exhibit at the Chief Poundmaker Museum west of the Battlefords. It also includes the artwork of Tyrone Tatusis and Henry Beaudry. Grainy photos and paintings tell Poundmaker's story. In May of 1885, federal troops attacked their band at Cutknife Hill, but were driven back. Poundmaker prevented his warriors from pursuing and slaughtering the retreating soldiers. Days later, Poundmaker surrendered and was convicted of treason. He died shortly after.
In terms of the legacy he left behind was something that we're now starting to see, finally. So it's year 2019, and it's been a work in progress. Deep passion he had was preserving our culture.
Tatusis hopes the museum exhibit will help Poundmaker members to take pride in their own history, and also for the general public to understand Poundmaker's role as hero, not villain.
We've been talking about it for years, and this, of course, this event will lead up to the formal exoneration of Chief Poundmaker, which is a date has yet to be confirmed. So I think it's safe to say the community in general is very, very excited.
On May 26th, he tried to be...
On Wednesday, Tatusis and others welcomed a school group from nearby Thunderchild Cree Nation, as well as their exchange student guests from Toronto. They said they learned a lot about Poundmaker and Plains Cree history.
It feels really good to see the culture and the history and to have people come here and learn about it.
With this cultural exchange, we are able to also pass on our beliefs, and with the same time, they're passing on theirs, their values, their cultural norms, and their way of life.
To celebrate the day, dozens have gathered here at the Poundmaker Band Hall for a solemn pipe ceremony and a large feast. The exhibits will be on display at the museum until May 9th. Jason Warwick, CBC News, Poundmaker Cree Nation.